despite the fact that this is Israel, we still have very, very difficult patients. And fortunately, the biology of hairy cell leukemia is now much better known. We know now that the combination of BRAF inhibitors with MEK inhibitors is very optimistic treatment. We know also that not only vemurafenib, but also but other BRAF inhibitors are active in hairy cell leukemia, for example, dabrafenib. So fortunately, I think for the treatment and drug availability, all patients with classic hairy cell leukemia have such mutations, and the drugs, targeted drugs, are active in most of them. So the future is to compare. In the future, we should analyze how deep remission we can obtain in patients who are not treated with furin analogs, but with new agents, with targeted drugs, how long the remission duration is, and how safe are these agents when we compare similar combinations. For example, BRAF inhibitors with rituximab combination and BRAF inhibitors with MEK inhibitors combination. But I think even greater challenge is the another form of hairy leukemia known as hairy cell leukemia variant. We recognized this disease many, many years ago, and we knew that hairy cell leukemia variant is refractory to, more refractory to purine analogs. The progression-free survival is shorter and remission is less pronounced than in classic hairy cell leukemia. In contrast to hairy cell classic form of hairy cell leukemia, hairy cell leukemia variant has not BRAF mutation. So BRAF inhibitors, dabrafenib, vemurafenib, are not active in this form of hairy cell leukemia, in hairy cell leukemia variant. And I think the major challenge is to find more effective treatment for this group of patients.